Look, I get it. Picking a storage drive for your next rig can be a difficult process. Currently, SSD prices are very respectable. You've got many storage options, many different speeds to consider, many different prices. I feel like this video is appropriate. And I must confess that this Reddit post, of all things, was what prompted me to create this video. Believe it or not, some good can come from that cesspool. We'll discuss that and more in this video. Not Reddit, but the SSDs. So here we go, another one for the Crash Course playlist. So there are two basic form factors you should keep in mind when choosing your next SSD, the 2.5-inch drive and the M.2 drive, much smaller. The former looks something like this. It's usually mounted to SSD trays in modern cases, though they can be placed really anywhere in a build, upside down, sideways, duct tape behind the motherboard tray. You get the point. A benefit of this style is freedom of placement. It'll work with really any relatively modern motherboard boasting SATA ports, I recommend SATA 2 or 3, and isn't composed of any moving parts, meaning they aren't as fragile as their hard drive counterparts. A few pros and cons of a 2.5-inch SSD. For one, because they use the SATA interface, you'll deal with higher latencies and lower bandwidth overall. And these drawbacks result in significantly slower effective transfer rates because the SATA interface is the bottleneck, typically in the realm of about 500 megabytes per second for both reads and writes, unless you have a crappy drive, and then typically the writes are trash and the reads are respectable. These speeds, mind you, are still several times faster than hard drives, meaning they'll still be the preferred OS drive. Expect boot times in the realm of about 10 to 15 seconds, depending on what you have loaded on the operating system. Two, slower drives using the SATA interface are much cheaper than their PCIe siblings, so these drives should be considered in more budget-oriented builds. 500GB 860 Samsung Evos, for example, these are great drives by the way, are only about 75 bucks each. I recommend these if you aren't looking to break the bank. I've linked them down below. I have first-hand experience with these. Even the 850 Evos were fine, but these for 75 or so US dollars are a steal. And three, you'll need to connect two external cables to these drives, one SATA data cable and one SATA power cable right next to it. It's the bigger one. Overall, just a tad more bulk added to your build, but again, definitely worth it if you're in the market for something relatively affordable and decent in terms of speed. The next SSD form factor is M.2. They're 22 millimeters tall and can range in basically length from 40 millimeters up to maybe 120, 140 millimeters. It really depends. Motherboards typically support all the different lengths, and the height, again, will be almost always 22 millimeters. M.2 actually stands for the second generation of mini SATA, hence the M in the name. The form factor attaches to the computer either via PCIe 3 and occupying up to 4 lanes, more on that in a second, or SATA 3 or USB 3. The physical connector for this kind of drive looks like this right here, I'll show a close up, which can be found on, again, most modern motherboards. Now, a common misconception here is that since these kinds of drives use a different connector, they must inherently operate at much higher or lower speeds, when in reality, the speeds of these drives are largely determined by the way in which data is transferred, not necessarily by the form factor. The diagram I mentioned earlier on Reddit comes in handy here, thanks to user Alex2003Super for the original post. The two technologies distinguishing M.2 drives apart are SATA and NVMe. We've already mentioned SATA, whose accompanying drive speeds max out at around 600 megabytes per second, which is why you aren't likely to find any SATA drive in either the M.2 or 2.5-inch form factor pledging a speed above this mark. The SATA interface would literally become the bottleneck. So this drive, for example, is a SATA M.2 drive. Notice how it doesn't promote transfer speeds above 600 megabytes per second. In fact, on the box, I don't even see it listed, and that's probably because it's nothing really to be excited about. If you want to pass this off as a much faster drive, just don't put how fast the drive is on the box. If it's going to be closer to 3,000 megabytes per second, you better believe that transfer speed is going to be on the box. So that's a way you could tell that this was a SATA M.2 just by looking at the transfer speeds. You could also tell by the physical connection on the M.2 drive. SATA M.2s are keyed twice. There is an exception to this, and we'll discuss that later in the video. Now, a few pros and cons of SATA M.2 SSDs are as follows. One, they're physically smaller. I mean, come on. Clearly smaller than their 2.5-inch counterparts, and can thus be easily installed into any compatible motherboard. Two, the board of course has to support the M.2 interface, right? But don't be just too disappointed here. Most boards will have at least one. I mean, heck, even the cheapest A320 board I could find on Amazon supported one. More on that in this video right here. And then three, these drives are roughly the same price as their 2.5-inch counterparts, though you may, well, actually I'm holding the wrong one. This is an M.2 NVMe drive. This one right here might cost just a tad bit extra over its equivalent 2.5-inch counterpart. But in general, if I had to choose between the M.2 form factor and the 2.5-inch form factor, I would choose this one simply because if I wanted to swap this out or maybe just remove it altogether, I don't have to remove, say, my graphics card to get to the M.2 drive, which is, that's typically where the port is between PCIe slots. It's more annoying to remove this, and that's really the only reason why I'd prefer this. Now, another kind of SSD we'll discuss in this video is the NVMe SSD. Now I can hold this thing. This is actually from Team Group. It's very fast, but also fairly expensive. NVMe stands for Non-Volatile Memory Express, and it's characterized by its high bandwidth and thus fast storage solutions. When memory is non-volatile, it simply means that it doesn't require power to retain stored information. You can power cycle your computer all day long, and unless the drive itself dies in the process, you'll be able to recover your data without loss. System RAM, like DRAM, is volatile, and on the other hand, and that basically means that the data is wiped from memory when current is cut. So that's why you can't use system RAM to store any important applications or data long term. We'll go into that in further detail in a future video. But for now, what you need to know is that NVMe storage drives, by nature of their protocols, are often extremely fast with respect to their inherent latencies and transfer speeds. The fastest NVMe SSDs I could find on the market exceed read and write speeds of 3500 and 2500 megabytes per second, or 3.5 and 2.5 gigabits per second respectively. That is lightning fast and would result in an incredibly snappy system overall. OS boot times are often under 5 seconds, can you imagine that? And any game saved to these drives load dozens of times faster than a typical hard drive. Once you go NVMe, it's very difficult to look back. Now, that's not to say that all NVMe SSDs are extremely fast. A subcategory of these drives relates to the number of PCIe lanes each occupies. So for instance, this drive right here is a 2-lane SSD, whereas this one is a 4-lane SSD. And the difference is basically, and if I wanted to generalize this, transfer speeds. Take this Samsung 970 Pro. It uses 4 PCIe lanes denoted by the X4 wording. This is what you want to look for when you're buying an NVMe SSD. 4 PCIe lanes have bandwidth equivalent to about 32 gigabits per second for basically 4 gigabytes per second. So theoretically, the fastest NVMe utilizing this interface would cap out at around 4,000 megabytes per second using the preferred SSD standard. Other NVMe's, however, like this one right here, are limited to just 2 lanes. So that means that theoretical transfer rates cap out at around 2 gigabits per second instead of 4. Moving from 2 to 4 lanes basically doubles your bandwidth. And this right here is an example of that. By the way, physically, 4-lane NVMe SSDs only have a single key. You can see there's just one little notch there. But a lot of the 2-lane NVMe SSDs will have 2 keys, just like their SATA M.2 counterparts. It's kind of confusing. I kind of expressed my frustration with this on Twitter, but some 2-lane NVMe SSDs will have just a single key, and some will have 2 keys like their SATA M.2 counterparts. So that's really not a great way. It's not an effective or reliable way of being able to figure out which is which, if it's 2 or 4 lanes. You have to just read the product description, make sure you know which one you're buying, and obviously you should look at the read and write transfer speeds because those will reveal how fast these drives are and typically how many lanes they're using. Now here are a few pros and cons of NVMe M.2 SSDs. One, obviously because they're much faster in general, they're more expensive, right? So typically around twice the price per gig or more or less depending, it depends on the market really, which has historically deterred a lot of PC builders. I've got only 2 4-lane NVMe SSDs in the studio and neither of them are in my personal rig. It's just, in my opinion, a better value to opt for the 2.5-inch or SATA M.2 drives. Two, many beefier NVMe drives will run very hot and may require heat sinks with active cooling to maintain adequate transfer speeds for long amounts of time. To be fair, all SSDs will throttle to an extent under heavy load, but this is something you should consider along with your use case scenario, since you're likely to spend hundreds of dollars on these drives. So you want to extract all the performance you really can. Now, the last kind of SSD we'll mention, just at least mentioned in this video, is the PCIe-based SSD. There isn't really much that sets these apart from their NVMe M.2 counterparts, save the interface used. In this case, it's PCI Express versus the M.2 port. Transfer speeds are essentially the same. In fact, you can buy little conversion cards that allow you to connect M.2s to those boards, and then thus connect those boards to the motherboard via the PCIe slot. So they're really the same thing. It's just the method by which you connect them to your system is a little different. PCIe-based drives aren't really as popular since they're much larger than M.2 drives and literally consume a slot on your motherboard. They're also typically more expensive, so it just really isn't ideal or functional. One benefit may be temperatures, where some PCIe NVMe's may have bulkier heat sinks or even fans, but but again, thermal throttling really only applies to those interested in transferring gigs of data at a time. By the way, I'm not going to discuss U.2 drives in this video. They aren't mainstream yet and are pretty expensive, assuming you can even find them in the consumer market. I have, however, linked a reliable article down below that may interest you regarding the technology and how it works. It is very well written. I've also attached affiliate links to several SSDs in various forms that I trust and have personal experience with for those interested in picking something up. They are also in the video description. Those kickbacks do go a long way. I appreciate it. If you guys like this video, thumbs up, you know what to do. Thumbs down for the opposite. Click that red subscribe button if you are feeling extra fancy, and I'll catch you in the next one. This is Science Studio. Thanks for learning with us.